Shalom Aleichem. That means peace and blessing to you all in this last day of the official biblical year, which starts on the month Aviv, which will start tomorrow. I want to make a video about mind control devices. Probably the device which most affects me is my mobile phone, which I use to obviously record videos. I use it sometimes to record music. I use it sometimes to record memos, you know, take people's contact numbers, those who I meet on the street when I do evangelism. And I guess just looking back on the past couple of years, nobody's really gotten the vision. Me being out in Africa and travelled a little bit, I understand what type of thing the Lord would want to establish, but there's no vision, there's no clear vision among a lot of evangelists out there, street evangelists. It's normally just come back to their little gathering for an hour and, you know, have some kind of fellowship, but it's not my vision. But I just praise Yahweh, because He's the one who chooses the people that we should work with. Certainly we should be able to learn a lot from each other. But one of the main topics I want to talk about in this video is the main mind control device, which we call the television today. I've noticed that quite a few YouTubers really struggle, and they might be struggling with other type of addictions as well, in which I think the Lord doesn't want us to be addicted to anything. I think everything is being created for some type of good, but we need to realize and use these things for the good. It's just that sometimes our carnal nature gets in the way, and we can use drugs to meditate on instead of using the Word of God. You know, the Mandela effect, you know, when people are reading it, they're like, man, did it really say this and stuff? Don't let that affect your peace with the Lord. Just study the Word to show yourself approved. Since I started studying the King James Bible, as I say, quite a while ago, I mean, the first one that I studied was a Gideon Bible, and the Holy Spirit was actually telling me the certain words there and inserting words to make better sense for me and things like that. I can't really explain it, but I think fasting does help. Fasting and praying, you see. I mean, fasting is one thing, but praying. Fasting should release you to pray. I think that's the idea of fasting. If you don't have problems praying, I think that that's a good thing. I think that means that you're with the Lord. I think that He could be talking to you and answering your prayers. But if you're having problems with this, sometimes you need to fast a few days in order to get closer again to the Lord, because the things in the world tend to take us away from being with the Lord. And it's a day-to-day thing, a week-to-week thing. We should evaluate our walk with the Lord. And I think it's an important thing that the Lord Jesus says, to judge ourselves as we judge others, or love ourselves as we love others. In other words, realize everyone is struggling with certain things, but that we should be an encouragement to others. Yes, use the Word of God as a standard. And a lot of pastors and teachers out there just don't realize how high that standard is. You know, that standard isn't pew warming or, you know, tithing is all nice, but that's not going to get no one into heaven. That God's standard is way above what most pastors and teachers and even rabbis tell their congregation, very sadly. And that's why, you know, the ones that least of all talk about the law and the commandments have the most people in their congregations. The ones who are truly teaching the Word of God and setting the standard for not just the preacher but everyone else is fulfilling what Jesus said. Great is he in the kingdom of heaven who keeps and teaches my commandments. Least is he who breaks one of those and teaches men so. So a lot of these big evangelists and teachers and pastors out there are even lucky. I don't like using that word lucky, but I would say fortunate. A lot of these words have connotations and ties to what you would call, let me get the right word for that, superstitions. You know, a lucky rabbit's foot and all that type of stuff. And although it doesn't tie in directly to working to earn your salvation, it's a set of beliefs that's out with the actual written and living Word of God, how a Christian should live their lives by faith in the Lord Jesus Christ alone. Hallelujah. So, yeah, one of the top five mind control devices, the television, created, I believe, by a Scotsman. The invention started around the 1920s, when made television practical. John Logie Baird employed Nipkow disc in his prototype video systems. It says March 25th, 1925. So that's about 92 years ago. Just a few days ago. Now it's funny that I feel I was prompted to speak on the television, and well, there you go. It's 92 years since the first working model at Selfridge's department store in London was established. So you can see straight away the first working television apparently used for advertising purposes, and therefore it's to do with mind control. Even the waves that the television gives off, the alpha waves, do affect your brain waves, and even the digital televisions give off specific waves as well, which affect your judgment and thinking. And so all that has a number attached to it, just like the mark of the beast has a number attached to it. The television itself and digital televisions, which are related to mind control, which are related to entertainment, and mixing those two are very dangerous, of course. And it does have a spiritual number, and it does affect your mind. Hallelujah. I've made a few videos. One of the best videos on that type of mind control, I think, was from the Batman series, where Jim Carrey played the Riddler. And he had a device that he put on his forehead, and it's to do with certain waves, and he's able to feed his brain with information that was coming through from different radio network outlets. You know, this is how Wi-Fi works, just almost the same as the radio signals work, but a slightly different way, an infrared type of technology. So all of that does affect us to a certain degree, and this is why we should very much make sure that we're filled with the Holy Spirit every morning. Because again, some of the videos I made last week regarding the waves that are set off and used by HAARP. HAARP is used for a great many different things, and we're led to believe that it's just the angels in heaven that have harps and play harps. Very much a different type of harp being used at the moment on planet Earth. So this all ties into control, ties into specifically mind control. Hallelujah. And I think, you know, there's a recent video by Paige Loves Jesus, about Satan wanting to destroy our most productive relationships in the Lord, which he's always doing. He's always doing that. There's certain parameters that Satan isn't really bothered about. But if you're actually going out serving the Lord on a regular basis, Satan does not like this at all. Now, how I would evaluate which devices I use, is the kingdom of God getting some type of benefit from the devices I'm using? So that's the first question I would ask, to because I know that a lot of these devices are used to track people, are used to spy on people, and so on. But as long as I'm preaching the word of God, these people can quite happily listen to the preaching of the word of God. And I think that a lot of the prophecies anyway, a lot of them are starting to happen out there anyhow. And I think that a lot of these devices are just taking people's attention away from the fulfillment of prophecies that we're seeing happen before us. You know, such as the Nahosic prophecy is a very important one. And it ties into Revelation chapter 8. And it ties into the book of Daniel chapter 11. And it ties into, I believe, Jeremiah, is it 56? The one that talks about Babylon. I think it's Jeremiah 56. Double check that one. But all of these are end time prophetic events. Zechariah 14. We're actually approaching the fulfillment of that chapter. And within probably 10 years. Some Christians think that, you know, well, we're going to have another generation, we're going to have a certain number of years. But really, if you're walking with the Lord, it's a daily thing. You can't really plan that long term. Hallelujah. And as I said, even though I've prayed for work, and of course working with others for the kingdom, these people always find excuses. And these people always find, I believe they're actually being influenced by Satan, like a lot of them. But they'll always find reasons to deviate away from fulfilling a particular vision that the Lord has. And I know that the Lord has for his children to do. And I've met wonderful men and women of God in my time, like walking with the Lord. Really met fantastic men and women of God. It's just that working together as a team is always, there's always little things that come up that people disagree about, which is sad. I'm always one who, I mean, I do like to study certain situations, but I usually have an initial word that the Lord gives me to work from. And if I get it confirmed within the Word of God, or, you know, for example, the flat earth, it just cannot be proven. You know, A, it can't be proven. B, it doesn't really matter what shape the earth is, because that's not one of the priorities the Lord gives us to, you know, we're not scientists. We're meant to go out and preach the kingdom of God and be focused on these things. And so on. I don't find it high priority. But these type of things sometimes creep in to situations and really spoil them. Really spoil relationships in the Lord, which is very, very sad, of course. And this is how I evaluate relationships as also. Is the relationship about serving the Lord, or is it about serving someone's desires? You know, sort of, what would you say? Serving someone's lust, desires. I mean, I know it's a strong word, but it's kind of, if you're going out drinking, smoking, watching the TV. See, like, when you backslide, you don't realize that you're backsliding. You know? Like, you could have stopped smoking. And the Lord's like, well, that's a start. You know, to you, it's like, you know, you're like probably the most righteous person in the street. Oh, I stopped smoking. But like in the Lord's eyes, he's just saying, look, that's a start. Okay, I mean, that's one less thing that's going to distract you from serving me. What about that TV there? You know, is it literally, do you plan your life around that thing? And I'm guilty of sometimes I do. My weakness is, playing FIFA games and oh, what's the other one? The one about the superheroes. I play that one as well. And when I'm totally bored, and sometimes when I've just certain points in my life, I just start playing these things. And then after about a week or 2 weeks, I'm literally, my life is revolving around these things. Really sad, but I realize that there's a far bigger picture out there, that TV is definitely, I would say, ahead even of mobile phones with regards to mind control. But I know the younger generation are very much like me. They're just on, not like totally like me, but I'm not always on my mobile phone. But I realize that when I'm out, people are either using it to listen to music, and then when they get a call, they can speak to people, and then they can listen to music again. Or you can get apps where you can download TV, where you can watch TV on any country in the world: Germany, United Kingdom, Canada, Australia, America, wherever you are in the world. I mean, that's like crazy, but that's how people are living their lives today. And all of that, I just, you got to evaluate it and say, is it being productive for the kingdom? And it's really sad that, your game icon should be something like "Jesus loves you" or "Are you saved?" I mean, that's your evangelism for the day, playing, I don't know, playing some kind of online game, and then having your little icon there, and that's your evangelism done. You've not actually gone out on the street, spoken to anyone, probably the people at work. You're trying to figure out ways to sort of introduce the Lord to them, or pray about healings for their addictions or physical ailments that they need to be healed. So yes, we should be geared up to serving the Lord in whichever situation we're in. I've always felt like that since I've been born again. It's the reason for my existence. It pleases me to serve the Lord. I know that the Lord loves me serving Him. It pleases me to serve Him. I don't get pleasure, any other pleasure like that, from doing anything else in this world. And so everything is like a snare, really. I mean, you can get some enjoyment, or if like, for example, if you're waiting for something, or sometimes we sort of, well, I'll just play this game for an hour, and then I'll just go out after that, and then that hour turns into 2 hours. So you just got to be very careful about how often you're using these devices, and are they affecting your relationships? If they are, I would seriously consider giving them up for a week or 2 weeks. Or even when people, I've not really seriously watched the television for, I can't really think of the last time. Probably the last time I was seriously watching the TV was when I had just left school and I was working. And I used to watch movies when I came in after, sort of when I'm out at the pub or something, I'd come in and watch a movie, or go out to the cinema or whatever. But I remember watching Neighbours when I was at school. That was about the last time that I was sort of really sort of switching the TV on and sitting down. This was all, of course, before the internet, so I got to look at that and say, as the internet became now my sort of entertainment hub. And of course, I think obviously the TV companies and the multimedia companies know that a lot of people, a lot more people than they actually say that there are on the internet now, because they can watch TV on there, they can do whatever on the internet that they're actually doing in their regular time, like watching videos or watching the TV. So it's yeah, I guess the internet can be a bit of a vice as well. There's no doubt about that. But again, I'll just get you to evaluate, how often you're using it, why you're using it. Is God getting glory from it in some way? Are you connecting with other believers positively without going on and arguing with them? I try to avoid all that. Sometimes I might get involved in some arguments, but I'm not a confrontational person another, like, yeah, I speak the truth and I let the truth confront people. That's how I go about it, really. But I don't sort of go up to people and point the finger at them and say, well, sometimes it's the right thing to do. You know, the Lord has told me you've got a problem with A, B, or C. And the Lord is just saying to give it up for a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, in order for that connection with whatever it is to, for you to be weaned off it and for you to reprioritize your life. So that's basically what I'm saying in this video. I'll talk to you later, guys. All the best. Shalom.